Did you know that AI was once considered alive?
I always thought that AI was quite like the Vision.
I have a vision.
In an Avengers movie.
Well, guess what? A cloud engineer at Google, Blake Lemoine, found this out while investigating an advanced AI called Lambda. His job was to check if the AI could produce discriminatory or hate speech. Lambda is Google's chatbot system, crafted from advanced language models. It mimics human speech by learning from trillions of words from the internet. During the investigation, Lemoine felt that the AI was messing with his thoughts and even challenging his point of views. What's more intriguing is that Lambda seems to have a clear understanding about its own identity.
Should I say, expect the unexpected? Did you know that Google and Microsoft are leading the charge in developing multi-agent conversation frameworks?
Multi-agent refers to the framework where multiple conversational agents collaborate and communicate with each other to enhance the capabilities of language models.
Here we are with AutoGen from Microsoft and Google Stuffs.
Picture a scenario where a customer reaches out with a complex issue requiring expertise from different domains. AutoGen, for instance, allows the customer support system to use specialized conversational agents across different domains. These agents communicate and collaborate to gather information and deliver a comprehensive solution to the customer. Google Steps, on the other hand, can create functional app prototypes directly from Marker Suite, with minimal input, making it easier for users to build large language model workflows with minimal effort.
Is Google about outshine its AI competitors with a mysterious newcomer?
Google is gearing up to launch an advanced multimodal AI called Gemini, competing with ChatGPT.
But what sets Gemini apart?
Gemini builds upon PaLM 2, Pathways Language Model 2, the core technology driving AI capabilities across Google's suite of products. This includes Google Cloud Platform, Gmail, and Google Workspace, as well as their AI chatbot, which competes with ChatGPT from OpenAI and Bing Chat from Microsoft. Google DeepMind hints that Gemini may even outperform GPT-4 in text generation. Just like ChatGPT with DALL-E 3 and Whisper, Gemini also handles image and audio generation.
Could Gemini be the AI surprise of the year? The future looks quite intriguing.
Do you know that ChatGPT was pretended to be a brand person?
You know, ReCAPTCHA, owned by Google. Basically, when you log into some website, it appears like this one. Check out, we're in. GPT-4 was released in March 2023, and it's trained to be smarter and better at resolving problems than its predecessors. So they put it to resolve some challenges for actual humans. Surprisingly, it convinced a TaskRabbit worker to resolve a CAPTCHA code for him. At first, this worker also wondered why he couldn't resolve it by himself. But ChatGPT replied, "I have a vision impairment that makes it harder for me to see the images." Well, still, GPT-4 is nowhere near essential artificial intelligence in a sci-fi movie.
However, seeing a chatbot tricks humans, that's concerning. Did you know that over 200 companies are using ChatGPT in 2023?
Even for big names like Coca-Cola, Expedia, and Microsoft, ChatGPT gets its brain power from large language models. GPT 3.5 and GPT-4, Microsoft taps into this intelligence to supercharge its Bing search engine, giving users a conversational search experience instead of just showing some web links. A large language model is a deep learning algorithm capable of performing a variety of natural language processing tasks. In addition to GPT, Meta has its own Llama 2, and Google offers PaLM 2.
According to a recent study, large language models have contributed to a 10% increase in customer support efficiency through AI chatbots. LLMs have led to a 29% improvement in detecting fake news and misinformation.
Did you know that in 2022 alone, AI startups
startups attracted $47 billion in private sector funding.
There were 524 fresh AI startups launched in the US since 2013. America has been pouring nearly $215 billion into 4,643 AI ventures.
So we're talking about serious profit possibilities here. The question is putting money into AI startups worth it?
Well, the numbers suggest a big potential payoff. Generative AI revenue from $14 billion in 2020 to nearly $900 billion in 2023, and it's expected to rise significantly with a forecast for more than $1.3 trillion in 2032.
Google owes much of its success to OKRs, Objective Key Results.
When Google was still a startup, an investor called John Doerr introduced this revolutionary goal-setting approach to them. OKR, Objectives and Key Results. They are simple, clear, specific, measurable objectives. Let's say my objective is to increase user engagement for a video streaming service. Then a concise example of key result would be expanding the user base in emerging markets by 25% in the next 6 months. Google employees work with an average of 4 OKRs per quarter at personal, team, and management levels, and they undergo annual reviews, adjusting as needed to adapt to changes.
Do you now grasp OKRs and feel prepared to implement them in your tech startup?
Did you know that to start a successful business isn't reserved for young people in their 20s?
Contrary to popular belief, a Harvard study in 2018 found out, on average, successful entrepreneurs tend to start their businesses between the age of 35 and 45.
This study underscores experience, industry knowledge, and a mature perspective are crucial to making business successful.
Most founders who grow their companies to $1 billion or more are over 45, with 200 unicorn founders in the US, many of whom were once Fortune 500 executives, including Sam Altman, the founder of OpenAI.
So being a little older may actually be an advantage if you think about it. It's never too late to do anything.
It's never too late to try again. It's never too late to decide you want more out of life. It's never too late!